Are you concerned about an earthquake destroying your glass jars? Hi, I'm Kyleen, the Provident Prepper. Glass jars are a fantastic storage container, except that they're fragile and they can break. After one of our last videos, one of our viewers shared with us her solution to keeping her jars safe in the event of an earthquake. She picks up regular banana boxes for free at a local grocery store and changes them up so that they're little jar jails for her bottles. In this video, we'll walk you through her process step by step. Recently, we created a video about how to store dry goods in glass jars for long-term storage. We absolutely adore our viewers, and we very much appreciate all the comments that are left because we learn so much from the wisdom and inspiration that's out there. One of our subscribers shared with us how she makes custom jar jail banana boxes, and I thought this was really cool, and asked her if she would be willing to share that information with us. In her original comment, she said, "I have started making jar jails for my glass jars. Banana box outside cover cut to form a grid, much like came with the ball jars, but a 4 or 5 grid, and this fits into another banana box bottom, and I use the inner banana box piece to close up the bottom of the box and on top of the jars too. If the jars are pints, I cut the bottom top and the bottom down to fit those jars. Out of 2 complete banana boxes, you can make 1 jar jail. Other jar sizes only fit a 3x4 grid, like some half-gallon pickle jars or 1-gallon jars are a 2x3 with some space left over. I think it's important to protect the jars after putting all that time and money, food, into them." And I completely agree, and I am so very grateful that she was willing to share this with us. This is not my original design. It is a brilliant design by a subscriber using free materials to meet the needs. This is the solution to the one big problem that we have with packaging food storage in glass jars, and that's the risk of breakage. And it's a real risk. So as I've been looking at this and experimenting a little bit with it, I think these jail jar banana boxes are a great solution. This is a picture of a banana box, and this is the raw material that you need. You actually need 2 complete banana boxes to create 1 jar jail. The only tools that are required are a knife and a sturdy pair of scissors that are strong enough to cut through the cardboard. Now, this is the template that you'll need to make to trace all the other pieces from. It is only 4 compartments wide, so you'll have to move the template over 1 space when tracing out the long side, which is 5 compartments long. Remember to make the gap in the cardboard wide enough to let the cardboard slide together easily. In this photo, you can see that there are 7 pieces cut out and ready for assembly. To assemble them, you just slide the pieces together for a nice snug fit. And then continue fitting the pieces together until the divider section is complete. All 7 pieces fit together to form this really nice bottle divider that will help to cushion the bottles in the event of an earthquake. Banana boxes are made out of incredibly sturdy cardboard. However, they do have a hole in the bottom. So the way that our subscriber fixed this problem is that she just cut a piece out of the other banana box that was large enough to cover the bottom of the box. This provides added support and fills that center hole. Once the bottom was strengthened with that additional piece of cardboard, the grid or the compartments are installed inside the box, and then the jars just nicely slide down into each one of those compartments. Once the box is filled with the jars, she places 1 additional piece of cardboard over the top for some additional protection. And finally, she takes a lid of the banana box, places it over her jar jail, and it is ready for storage. Now she stacks the jar jails with pieces of 3/4-inch plywood in between to help support the center of the box. The plywood is about 1/2 inch bigger on each side than the box itself. I think this is a fantastic free solution to protect glass jars from breaking in the event of an earthquake. And one of the wonderful things about this jar jail is that it can be customized to fit just about any size jars. Thank you very much to our subscriber who has chosen to remain anonymous. And thank you to all of you for the wonderful contribution that you make in the comments, because there are so many people that read those comments, and together we can learn from each other and become better than we could ever be on our own. I'd like to direct you to our YouTube channel and to some of the really cool videos that we have that you might be interested in. The first video is the one that our subscriber commented on about how she stores her jars. And that's glass jar food storage. In this video, we talk about how to store dry goods in glass jars and package them for long-term storage. Another is plastic bottle food storage, which is very similar, only it uses peat bottles that you would normally throw away to store your dry goods. Mylar bag food storage is another way that you can package foods at home for long-term storage. And then another one is how to build your survival food supply. It's so important that we have a full pantry in our home. And there are some tips and tricks that can help you to better plan and have a better outcome when it comes to building your family food supply. So check these out. And thanks for being part of the solution and for being a wonderful member of our community. What a great, inexpensive solution to keep your glass jars safe. And now for the question of the day. How do you protect your glass jars from breaking in the event of an earthquake? Comment below. And thanks for being part of the solution.